BeamBrush is a new element inside your laser projector, and thus we've added several features that support this new control parameter of laser projectors. In this video, we'll talk about the extra added features. Creation tools that we've added and setup tools we have added are in separate videos. First, general addition is the BeamBrush Attenuation Map. This works similar to how beam attenuation maps work for brightness, but we've added it for brush amount. The BeamBrush Attenuation Map is located in projection zones. Beam Attenuation Map, Beam Brush Map. Here you can enable the brush attenuation map for the zone and use this exactly like beam attenuation map. You can create a new map, copy and paste options, and your drawing options with the pencil tool, sprayer tool, eyedropper, and paint can tool. You can also just use the square selection and gradient selections. Use the laser cursor to help you identify in real life what areas you're adjusting. This is an example of what your brush map might look like with the divergence of the laser increasing as it goes lower into the audience. The only main difference here between beam attenuation and brush attenuation is that black and 0% means zero brush, and white and 100% means full brush. This scales based on your maximum brush set in your projector settings. The most important thing to remember with any attenuation map is the operation order. Use this option first if you want your map to be scaled within and move within the geometric correction of the zone, or use the second option if you want the brush map to be over the whole potential zone area and not move or scale with geometric correction. The next addition is about laser preview window and how brush is scaled and previewed. Go to Settings, Configuration, Laser Preview. Here you can see this new addition of Max Beam Brush Width. This changes how large the brush will look in the preview window and in your previews inside of your grid. We recommend 7 at 100 for default, as this looks as close to real life as a projector at 60 degrees for graphics. We do this for programming purposes, as we can always scale smaller instead of larger if needed. If your output seems smaller than the preview, you can lower the first value, and if it seems larger than the preview, then you can increase the first value. Another feature we've added in the Configuration tab for BeamBrush is under the Network tab. While we hope all visualizers will support BeamBrush, we have added a checkbox to enable or disable BeamBrush being sent over visualization, as most visualizing software won't see the data stream if BeamBrush is included, and you may need to disable it for the visualizer to work. The Frame Analyzer is a tool that lets you see all data about a single laser frame to help you optimize and determine the difficulty of the frame to be displayed by a laser. It is located under Tools, Frame Analyzer. We have added a BeamBrush area to the Frame Analyzer to help you check the potential performance of a frame or queue. And as the BeamBrush mechanism is driven by a scanner, we have previewed it like a scanner. The last general addition to Beyond we have made is adding a live control slider for BeamBrush. This is located under the RGBA area and is additive, so I'll add the slider value to all the values in a frame instead of overriding. When a value reaches maximum brush, it just stays there. If you do not see the RGBA panel in the Live Control tab, go to Settings, Configuration, Live Control, and enable Show RGBA Panel. This slider is also part of the object tree and can be MIDI mapped. Its Pango script code is BeamBrush and the value. You can see it in the preview window here. Thanks for watching our quick ins video on the general additions to Beyond for BeamBrush. If you still have questions or need help, email support@pangolin.com and we can assist as soon as possible. And be sure to watch our other quick ins videos on the BeamBrush additions to Beyond to get the full picture.